I'm sure our representatives have a number of questions to pose to you. It's a very... yes. Let me also invite on stage WION's Karthikeya Sharma, and over to the audience. I'm sure a number of questions on everyone's minds. It's been a very comprehensive deconstruction, sir, but, and I have to say that it's a very optimistic note on which we are ushering in the new year.
Thank you, Molly. And before we engage with the floor, my humble request is raise your hand, identify yourself, and then I'll come to you. But before that, before I engage with the floor, I have a question for the minister. You know, it's very rare to see a union minister make such a extempore speech, and that to a PPT base. I have not seen that 20, 22 years of my career on a subject like this, which is a hard subject. You know, I read your article.
That's a compliment.
It's a compliment.
I happily accept it.
It's a compliment.
But I don't want this to be a reflection on my other colleagues. Well, there are several of them who make better extempore speeches. Just invite them.
Oh, absolutely. But it's a compliment. You know, I read your article. And
this morning's article.
Maybe I think you wrote it a week back, but there was a line in it. And you said that, you gave a reference of 1933. You said that the initiative by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, which is about a number of schemes in urban spaces, including Smart City, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana and other schemes, it's like the New Deal. Why did you use the word New Deal? New Deal pulled America out of recession. India's growth rate is not good. Do you think that this whole imagination of reinventing, reviving urban space can really pull India out?
Well, it's not whether it can. It is pulling India out. China had the same problem in 2006 and 2007, and they used the construction momentum and boom there to get out of it. Different thing what happened then. Look, we are today allowing ourselves to be subjected to a number of false narratives. When you refer to an article this morning, I thought you were referring to the one I wrote in the Hindustan Times on the Citizenship Amendment Act. But look, what are the false narratives here? The first false narrative which comes from those who in their extended tenure in government, when their own record can be, why do I do it in Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana? Just check the figures under JNURM. That was their housing scheme. We've done four times that in half the time, number one. I am not saying, you see, I can come and give you a political discourse which will sound different. I am putting in front of my friends in the construction industry the figures for how much of cement and steel you are going to use just to complete the figures under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban. And I've given you a precise figure. The 40 lakh tons is what has been used. You can verify that. Look, we cannot go wrong. Why are we allowing ourselves to be subjected to this, what I call dumbing down and I wouldn't say doomsday, but a gloom scenario. That, you know, oh my God, India not... You know, I was in Singapore. I must tell you this, you'll enjoy this because you're a global outreach channel. Somebody there tells me, you know, your growth rate is coming down to... Those days it was coming down to 6% or something like that. So I had the... I felt like... I didn't. I'm a trained diplomat. I spent 40 years in that profession. I wanted to ask the guy, you know, fancy this coming from you. Your growth rate is 0.6%. So, but I didn't put it like that. I said, look, my answer, and that's my answer to you. You've had 11 years of expansion. 11 years. Okay? You have grown in those 11 years. Even a year ago, our figure was what? 8%? 8%, Lakshmi was telling me. You acknowledge that you've had 11 years of expansion. You also acknowledge that there are cyclical factors. You also acknowledge that there is a global environment. I don't want to get into a game of relative weightage. If it is cyclical, then as per definition, this should turn around after some course correction. Real estate is a sector where the course correction has to take place. Our property is highly overpriced, whether the real estate sector, they've enjoyed themselves. I've lived in New York. And sometimes when Lakshmi and I used to look at property prices in New York, we used to say, my God, this is much cheaper than what you would pay in a reasonable colony in Delhi. So that correction will take place. But I'm saying something else. There is also something called an external environment. So between the cyclical and the global environment and the fact that you've had 11 years of expansion, I am not only sure, but if I had money, I don't. I'd bet my bottom dollar that you are seeing already that turnaround. I gave you those figures of public transport, the metro. Look at the automobile industry. People are already beginning to. If there is a marginal correction and there's a falling 1 or 2% in automobile sales, don't give us gloomy. The entire automobile sector is going to collapse. Never happens like that.
Okay.
What will happen is some course correction will take place, but I am confident that when you see a balancing take place.
So you're saying basically it's a course correction.
Well, I'll give you another sector. I'm also Minister for Civil Aviation. We had a major airline ceasing operation between December of 2018 and April of 2019. I become minister in June. Civil Aviation was in June, yeah. After the last election. 1st June or so, 30th May, I become Civil Aviation Minister. I am subjected to public scrutiny. Civil aviation sector has collapsed totally. Arre bhai, civil aviation sector collapsing totally, you should see what that kind of discourse means and what the implications are. My dear friend, let me share a statistic with you. That airline ceased operation somewhere between December of 2018 and April of 2019. I got the figure of year on year, November to November. November was a year when that airline was fully operational. The growth between November of 2018 and November of 2019 is 11.03%. Does this look like a sector which is collapsing? I give you another statistic. October is the month in which Diwali takes place. Diwali is a time when a lot of travel takes place. Month on month between October and November, there is a rise of 3%, and year on year, there is a rise of 11%. I am making a statement on the record that, look, whatever happened in a particular airline, it ceased operations. I'm not going to go into the reason because these are matters.
Basically,
before.
You're saying it's a correction. That's the
not a correction. It's a huge growth, and we are going to go with an 8% penetration into solid double-digit growth in civil aviation.
Okay. Okay, any questions from the floor? Yes. Okay, please go ahead.
Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. S.K. Datta. Sir, I have a broader question, and that is in relation to Delhi and the rest of the country. My first question is specific to Delhi itself. Delhi, a major problem in Delhi is like the water logging, which we have during the time of monsoon, and whenever there is rain, it's all water everywhere. As far as I understand, the system of drainage in Delhi was done in such an unsystematic way that it has landed us up in a kind of a collapse. And the Najafgarh Barapula Nala, the elevated road over that. That is another very big cause of this menace as such. So to my knowledge, I think there is absolute zero cooperation on behalf of the Delhi government when it comes to all these issues with the central government.
You don't use with cooperation. You see, if there's cooperation, the figure has to be higher than zero.
Yes,
see,
it is non-cooperation.
No, it's...
What's the question, sir?
My question is what is the central government thinking of eradicating all these issues?
It's very simple. The answers to most of the problems are very simple. Look, I'll tell you, let's come to water. Water is a national problem. The Prime Minister recognizes it. Prime Minister has set up a separate Jal Shakti ministry under the stewardship of one of our most competent ministers. Okay, that's one. Secondly, why does water logging take place? I will tell you, you don't need a rocket science. Many of us have followed our traditional habits. Ghar mein safai karo, ghar ke koode ko bahar phenko. This is a smaller part which I can resolve. But if a commercial establishment which runs as a restaurant, cuts its vegetables and does everything and then ultimately throws all the vegetable leftovers, etc. into the nearest nala, you'll be blocking the nalas. I'm giving you a very simplest thing. Let me tell you, Delhi Jal Board, DUSIB, I can give you hundreds of examples where organization under the Delhi government did not only not do their work, there has been criminal abdication of responsibility. This problem in Delhi we can solve out. Delhi, we are still well organized. You know, there is civic consciousness. You guys come on our TV screen. You put the government of the day in the center or the state on the mat. There is civil society. There are NGOs dealing with it. But you have to do it for the rest of the country. That's why we have a Jal Shakti ministry.
So, you had a question?
So I'm Shabnam Singhal. I run a real estate company called Sirius, and also happen to be a big supporter of BJP and family also. I would like to first congratulate you on achieving the integrated management. I have two questions. One is, we meet a lot of funds. They're very focused on the NCR. We are presently doing a project for one of the sponsors over here. They have about 7 to 8 projects coming up in areas like Chandigarh. And we always right now are facing a difficulty, even after having been a part of IVCA, which is India Venture Capitalist Association. The total investment of the international funds is around 43,000 crores. They're right now struggling with the finance ministry for some basic GST compliances. And the other thing is, sir, I would also try and request you to humbly look into the retail section. It gives a lot of employment. The Blackstones, the Kotaks, every single person is willing to give a 5x amount, but there is no real person. Yes, it's great to concentrate on the basic, but these other projects also do give us a lot of income. And I mean, whether you look at...
Look, there's nothing that you're saying which I either disagree with or where I would have an issue. Let me tell you, the issue is quite simple. When you have a sector, and it's an entire sector, vitiated due to bad habits which had got institutionalized, I turn around and say the real starting point of resolving that issue has to come through the establishment of a regulator. I'm sorry, I'm going to repeat myself, but I want to tell you what exactly was happening here. What was happening here is, because we had a parallel economy, we still do. None of us is saying it's all gone, but we made a major effort to correct it. There was a culture of impunity. Anybody who had income from whatever, which was not accounted for, instead of keeping the money in gunny bags at home and, you know, risking a visit by the taxman or some other state agency, would take that and go through word of mouth to your neighbor's house if you found out he was a builder or a promoter and said, aap agla project karenge, hamare bhi naam do flat kar dena. You didn't count what was in the bora, he didn't count it either, there was a rough this thing, you got a letter, the guy didn't look at the letter, at what was the date of completion. It was chaos. We corrected that. Today I was in a press conference giving figures. We had something like 40,000 plus projects registered. We got some 34,000 real estate agents registered. Some 34,000 disputes have been solved. Now we come to a second thing. And you know, the industry, Naredco, Credai, all the others come to me regular basis, whether they are BJP or not. I mean, when you're from BJP, as far as I'm concerned, that's a plus plus. But even the others, they come to me, we take all the good ideas, and what do? We implement them. Mm-hmm. We implement them either directly or we go to the finance ministry and say, I think one of the issues which we have to confront with is that liquidity, there is an issue. But the liquidity issue arose because your banks were under stress. Because your banks were under stress, the NBFCs also came under stress. But today we have to look at it somewhat differently. In order for real estate to be totally this thing, when you go to a bank or an NBFC and ask for money against land, you won't get it. We need to address those issues. And therefore, you must have a situation where, you know, this is just the step, first step. The Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Because today you have a situation, you have a $3 trillion economy, but very low per capita income. The Prime Minister's name will be written in golden letters. He was able to see a problem when we have low per capita income. By the year 2024, if you are a $5 trillion economy, your per capita income would have doubled. By the time you're in 2030, you're a $10 trillion economy, you'll be the third largest economy in the world, your per capita income will go up 4 times. Jo aap problems batari will not arise then. You know why? Because housing then will become much more dynamic in terms of people buying and selling and going on. And for the promoters to be able to raise funds for project as anywhere else in the world. If the kind of speculation which took place in land, you know what people did. When a buyer, when a builder or a promoter took money from home buyers, many of them were innocent people who put their hard-earned money, took loans, paid EMIs to bank. Some of them were speculators. Put that aside. When you got that money, I'm not talking about you, but the builders or promoter, they invested it in land banks because there was so much money chasing the land banks, land value drop. Now, this kind of thing cannot be allowed to happen. So the RERA now introduces a clause which says you have to set up an escrow account and 70% of the proceeds of that from a particular project have to go into that account. So it's not likely to happen again. But what you're saying, I totally agree. Whether it is venture capitals or others, I think we have to sit down. And I think the mature, and it'll happen when the real estate market picks up, etc. If we sort out the basic issues, we go into then some of these issues, and I'm ready for a discussion with the real estate industry anytime.
Okay, this is the last question from the floor.
All right. So I'm Yoginder Kapoor, chartered accountant by profession. Now, the government needs experts and specialists, as just vetted by the Commissioner DDA also, for the development of smart cities. The industry has the experts and specialists. My first question is, why is the fusion not taking place? The second point is that, coming to the PPP model, now we see a situation.
You're really falling short of time. I think you should stick to your first question, sir.
No, I'm quite happy to. First of all, I take issue with the fundamental premise. Why is fusion not taking place? It is taking place. It is taking place. No. I know her very well. I work with her on a daily basis. I know what she would have said. Look, the India of 2030 will be transiting to an urban India when you're 40% of your population. All your urban local bodies will require complete professionals coming in from the outside, which means you don't need general level administrators. You will need urban specialists, architects, town planners, etc. To the extent that you have the people, they are being used. But let's acknowledge another major thing which is staring us in the face. When I look around for expertise, I don't have it. Because you never imagined that
town planners,
there aren't enough around.
Yes, absolutely.
I'm doing a big project on Central Vista, and we had an open design competition. Now people who are coming and offering their comments, I welcome each one of them. But I'll give you another example. Who is heading the smart, the special purpose vehicle? You've got experts coming in from the private sector. I mean, the guy who's heading it in Goa, I'm not trying to advertise one person, is a professional. He was working with the UN in Geneva or somewhere. They're coming. So to the extent you have the experts, they're being absorbed. What you have to be very careful on is the person coming and offering himself. Don't start with a fundamentally flawed premise that, you know, experts are not coming forward. Hey, wait a minute. This is the marketplace. A good expert who has domain knowledge, who has written books, who has done consultancy work, is ready for a deployment. They will join the National Institute of Urban Affairs. They will join the smart city projects in the special purpose vehicles. They will offer their services as advisors to politicians and so on.
And so last question, because, you know, the cue in my ear is that, you know, I really have 3 minutes left with me. This is one question I wanted to ask you in the first go itself. You know, cities represent philosophy, they represent a worldview of the time, the architecture, you speak about the food, the costume, the way power is structured, division of labor. So what is the philosophy behind rebuilding of the Central Vista? What is going to be preserved and what's going to be done away with?
I'm glad you asked this question, because I may have forgotten it, but it gives me just the opportunity I'm looking for. Look, in 1911, when you started designing these iconic buildings, okay, Rashtrapati Bhavan, North Block, South Block, Parliament, in 1911, they were completed, I think, 1922. Did you even realize that you were going to be an independent country in 1947? First question. You became an independent country in 1947. Your population was 350 million. In 2030, which is just a few years away, when you'd still be a very young person and I'll be in old age, by that time, these buildings, you know, many of them are not earthquake proof. Many of them are guzzlers of electricity and energy, but I'm not saying all that. it is incumbent on every government, every governing structure to occasionally look beyond today and tomorrow and to plan for the next 100 years. First of all, and I want to use this on a public platform like WION, which is a respectable medium, nothing which is heritage of etc. is going to be dismantled. So don't listen to this completely. Uninformed is too mild a word. Some people are trying to, you know, I wrote an article in Hindustan Times, I said misleading at the least, but treacherous at worst. There's this rumor around that all these iconic buildings will come down. Nothing will come down, number one. Do you know how much rent we pay for government buildings in Delhi alone? Guess, if you want to hazard a guess? 1,000 crores per year. Here we are owners of the land and we are paying 1,000 crores of rent everywhere. So what we are going to do is we will take that Central Vista. In one case alone, in Central Vista, I think I started my professional career, Lakshmi and I, in South Block, which houses the External Affairs Ministry after the PMO. There's about 60, 70 acres of what you call Hutment's area there. Suboptimal utilization of land, stuff which would have been, you know, brought down. So all your iconic building, my friend.
Like Parliament?
Parliament will remain as it is. But the problem with Parliament is, let me explain to you, this is where I'm trying to correct it. You see, this Parliament will remain as it is. But you'll have to build something more. Do you know what happens? In the Rajya Sabha, I'm in the second row, which is one of the privileged rows. The gap between my knees and that one is very little. If I'm in the fourth row, which I used to be, I mean, you could barely get in if somebody has to get in. You know, if you have a central, I mean, any parliament in the world must have a place where the honorable member can sit, where he can have a researcher who can have a computer and guide him on the interventions you're going to make.
Okay.
Each one must have a separate room. Today we have a situation, if you have to a joint session of parliament, you must have it in the central hall. And no MP has a room. My boss once asked me a question, and this is in lighter vein. He said, "Tumhe pata hai ye mantri kyun banna chahte hain?" Referring to MP. He said, "Mantri bante hain to kamra mil jata hai unko." Which is absolutely hard truth. I mean, there must be other reasons they want to be minister. That's a separate issue. But what I'm saying is, one, when you see the design of Central Vista, all these people who've seen it so far, they've been raving about it. But there are some people who are trying to cast doubts. They've been fed misinformation. You will get, after the Central Vista construction is over,
okay.
First criticism was that everything will be destroyed, people will be living in tents. I don't know where that came from. People will be moving to their new offices. It will be done sequentially. All government offices will be...
Heritage will be preserved.
Absolutely. Anyone who's suggesting anything otherwise, I mean, don't tell me Loknayak Bhavan is heritage.
No, absolutely. But I mean, it was Parliament.
Or that Shastri Bhavan is heritage. I'll tell you a story. I was a young press officer in 1978 and a very famous English, British journalist wrote something in Moraji's time, but I won't go into it just now. I think I'll publish it somewhere. Look, all heritage buildings will be, and heritage is defined in a long-term context. So no one has any idea like that. So all is not ill-conceived. It's no longer ill-conceived. Much of what is being sent about the Citizenship Amendment Act is pure lies. And this, what I'm hearing about the Central Vista is also pure fabrication. And incidentally, on the 30th of this month is, I think, Monday.
Mm-hmm.
I am going to actually, under controlled conditions, we have to do public consultation on it. Maybe you will provide a venue on that. I'm calling about 30 people.
Okay.
30 people, many of them, town planners, architects, people who know about urban space, to get a basic presentation. I am also, on that occasion, calling a few senior journalists. I can't call everybody at all.
Okay.
After that, we will follow it up with more public...
But I think you have put a lot of doubts to rest, and I'm really happy that you could make time for our Mission Cities 2020.
Did I have a choice? No, I'm very happy to be here. But I want to tell you one thing. Look, it's my job as the Minister for Housing and Urban Affairs to get what my ministry is doing out into the public domain. And you provide an opportunity for me to do that.
Thank you.
And you do it in a professional way, where I'm allowed to interact, where I'm allowed to speak.
But I'm glad that you spoke about the Central Vista. As a journalist, as a person who has lived in Delhi for 40 years, as a child, as a student, as a professional, to have this sort of an assurance from the minister that the heritage would be preserved.
100%. I've had an editorial written on me.
That's a good note to end this program. Molly, to you.
Well, thank you very much. All I wanted to tell you is somebody wrote an editorial on this, and I was sufficiently motivated. I told my young colleague here, I said, usko bhi lunch pe bula lo, jisne editorial likha. Look, a government which is elected with a majority is a government which is sensitive to public opinion. But forgive me if I say, if that opinion is being manipulated and outright lies are being peddled, as I said on the Citizenship Amendment Act, then you know you must realize that some of us will react on it in a hard-hitting way, which I've done in my piece this morning. But on Central Vista, relax. You will also get the presentation, but I have to, because I have a few other things to do. The first presentation was made to the presiding officers of the two houses, the Honorable Vice President and the Speaker. After that, we've done to other dignitaries, VVIPs. We are now going to have a controlled session with opinion makers, with architects, etc. And what is most important, we are only at the stage of inviting ideas. If during a presentation I say that this heritage building is going to go down, will I not get a reaction? And on the other hand, when you say this is very good. But on the other hand, I hope that exchange of ideas is a two-way process. It's not that that person has won a design competition which was open to all companies in the world. 27 applied, 6 of them were shortlisted. So the jury which was there is amongst the most eminent people in that field, headed by people who are holding the highest offices. So this is a process we've been through. And as I said, if there is something in the presentation, I'm not saying if you come up with an idea, but if there is a feeling that there's something needs to be rectified, I'm sure the person who's finalizing the plan would be happy.
I think people in this room and also those watching are extremely glad, sir, that you could take out the time and comprehensively break down for us what India's Smart City design is looking like. Appreciate very much, sir, your joining us.
Well, so, I want to thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Round of applause, please, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.